Jamie Dimon is an American billionaire businessman. He is the chairman and chief executive officer of JPMorgan Chase, the largest of the big four American banks, since 2005 and was previously on the board of directors of the Federal Reserve Bank of New York. Dimon was included in Time magazine's 2006, 2008, 2009, and 2011 lists of the world's 100 most influential people. Dimon's net worth is estimated at $1.70 billion. Dimon is one of the few bank chief executives to become a billionaire, thanks in part to a $485 million stake in JP Morgan Chase. He received a $23 million pay package for fiscal year 2011, more than any other bank CEO in the U.S. However, his compensation was reduced to $11.5 million in 2012 by JP Morgan Chase following a series of controversial trading losses amounting to $6 billion. Dimon received $29.5 million in fiscal year 2017. Chapter 1: Early Life and Education. Dimon was born in New York City, one of three sons of Greek immigrants Theodore and Themis Dimon, and attended the Browning School. His paternal grandfather was a Greek immigrant who changed the family name from Papadimitrio to Dimon to make it sound more French, and worked as a banker in Smyrna and Athens. He has an older brother, Peter, and a fraternal twin brother, Ted. Dimon's father and grandfather were both stockbrokers at Shearson. He majored in psychology and economics at Tufts University, where he graduated summa cum laude. At Tufts, Dimon wrote an essay on Shearson mergers. His mother sent the paper to Sandy Weil, who hired Dimon to work at Shearson doing budgets during one summer break. After graduating, he worked in management consulting for 2 years before enrolling at Harvard Business School, along with classmates Jeff Immelt, Steve Burke, Stephen Mandel, and Seth Klarman. During the summer at Harvard, he worked at Goldman Sachs. He graduated in 1982, earning an MBA as a Baker Scholar. After graduation from Harvard Business School, Sandy Weil convinced him to turn down offers from Goldman Sachs, Morgan Stanley, and Lehman Brothers to join him as an assistant at American Express. Although Weil could not offer the same amount of money as the investment banks, Weil promised Dimon that he would have fun. Dimon's father, Theodore Dimon, was an executive vice president at American Express. Chapter 2: Career. Chapter 2, Section 1: Commercial Credit and Transition into Citigroup. Sandy Weil left American Express in 1985 and Dimon followed him. The two then took over Commercial Credit, a consumer finance company, from Control Data. At 30 years of age, Dimon served as the chief financial officer, helping to turn the company around. Through a series of mergers and acquisitions, in 1998 Dimon and Weil were able to form a large financial services conglomerate, Citigroup. Dimon left Citigroup in November 1998, after being asked to resign by Weil during a weekend executive retreat. It was rumored at the time that he and Weil argued in 1997 over Dimon's not promoting Weil's daughter, Jessica M. Biblioes, although that happened over a year before Dimon's departure. At least one other account cites a request by Dimon to be treated as an equal as the real reason. Chapter 2, Section 2: Move to JP Morgan. In March 2000, Dimon became CEO of Bank One, the nation's fifth largest bank. When JP Morgan Chase purchased Bank One in July 2004, Dimon became president and chief operating officer of the combined company. On December 31, 2005, he was named CEO of JP Morgan Chase, and on December 31, 2006, he was named chairman and president. In March 2008, he was a Class A board member of the Federal Reserve Bank of New York. Under Dimon's leadership, with the acquisitions during his tenure, JP Morgan Chase has become the leading U.S. bank in domestic assets under management, market capitalization value, and publicly traded stock value. In 2009, Dimon was considered one of the top gun CEOs by Brendan Wood International, an advisory agency. On September 26, 2011, Dimon was involved in a high-profile heated exchange with Mark Carney, the governor of the Bank of Canada, in which Dimon said provisions of the Basel III international financial regulations discriminate against US banks and are anti-American. On May 10, 2012, JPMorgan Chase initiated an emergency conference call to report a loss of at least $2 billion in trades that Dimon said were designed to hedge the bank's overall credit risks. The strategy was, in Dimon's words, flawed, complex, poorly reviewed, poorly executed, and poorly monitored. The episode was investigated by the Federal Reserve, the SEC, and the FBI, and the central actor was labeled with the epithet the London Whale. Dimon commented on the Volcker Rule in January 2012, part of the Volcker Rule I agreed with, which is no prop trading. But market making is an essential function. And the public should recognize that we have the widest, the deepest, the most transparent capital markets in the world. And part of that is because we have enormous market making. If the rules were written as they originally came out, I suspect they'll be changed. It would really make it hard to be a market maker in the United States. He served as chairman of the Executive Committee of the Business Council for 2011 and 2012. On January 24, 2014, it was announced that Dimon would receive $20 million for his work in 2013, a year of record profits and stock price under Dimon's reign, despite significant losses that year due to scandals and payments of fines. The award was a 74% raise, which included over $18 million in restricted stock. This is despite the recent $13 billion settlement with the US government, the largest in history, for bad mortgages and practices during the financial crisis. Forbes reported that, in a statement following news of Dimon's compensation, the bank said, "Under Mr. Dimon's stewardship, the company has fortified its control infrastructure and processes and strengthened each of its key businesses while continuing to focus on strengthening the company's leadership capabilities across all levels." Chapter 2, Section 3, Federal TARP Funds. As head of JPMorgan Chase, Dimon oversaw the transfer of $25 billion in funds from the U.S. Treasury Department to the bank on October 28, 2008, under the Troubled Asset Relief Program. This was the fifth largest amount transferred under Section A of TARP to help troubled assets related to residential mortgages. It has been widely reported that JPMorgan Chase was in much better financial shape than other banks and did not need TARP funds but accepted the funds because the government did not want to single out only the banks with capital issues. JPMorgan Chase advertised in February 2009 that it would be using its capital-based monetary strength to acquire new businesses. By February 2009, the US government had not moved forward in enforcing TARP's intent of funding JPMorgan Chase with $25 billion. In the face of the government's lack of action, Dimon was quoted during the week of February 1, 2009, as saying, "JPMorgan would be fine if we stopped talking about the damn nationalization of banks. We've got plenty of capital. To policymakers, I say, where were they? They approved all these banks. Now they're beating up on everyone, saying look at all these mistakes, and we're going to come and fix it." JPMorgan Chase was arguably the healthiest of the nine largest US banks and did not need to take TARP funds. In order to encourage smaller banks with troubled assets to accept this money, Treasury Secretary Henry Paulson allegedly coerced the CEOs of the nine largest banks to accept TARP money under short notice. Chapter 2, Section 4, Political Endeavors. Dimon donates primarily to the Democratic Party. In May 2012, he described himself as barely a Democrat, stating, "I've gotten disturbed at some of the Democrats' anti-business behavior, the attacks on work ethic, and successful people. I think it's very counterproductive. It doesn't mean I don't have their values. I want jobs. I want a more equitable society. I don't mind paying higher taxes. I do think we're our brother's keeper, but I think that attacking that which creates all things is not the right way to go about it. After Obama won the 2008 presidential election, there was speculation that Dimon would serve in the Obama administration as Secretary of the Treasury. Obama eventually named the President of the Federal Reserve Bank of New York, Timothy Geithner, to the position. Following the acquisition of Washington Mutual by JPMorgan Chase, Obama commented on Dimon's handling of the real estate crash, credit crisis, and the banking collapse affecting corporations nationwide, including major financial institutions like Bank of America, Citibank, and Wachovia. You know, keep in mind, though, there are a lot of banks that are actually pretty well managed, JP Morgan being a good example. Jamie Dimon, the CEO there, I don't think he should be punished for doing a pretty good job managing an enormous portfolio. Dimon has had close ties to some people in the Obama White House, including former Chief of Staff Rahm Emanuel. Dimon was one of three CEOs, along with Lloyd Blankfein and Vikram Pandit, said by the Associated Press to have had liberal access to former Treasury Secretary Timothy Geithner. Nonetheless, Dimon has often publicly disagreed with some of Obama's policies. On the May 15, 2012, episode of ABC's The View, Obama responded to a question from Whoopi Goldberg regarding JPMorgan Chase's recently publicized $2 billion trading losses by defending Dimon against allegations of irresponsibility, saying, "First of all, JPMorgan is one of the best managed banks there is. Jamie Dimon, the head of it, is one of the smartest bankers we've got," but added, "It's going to be investigated." In December 2016, Dimon joined a business forum assembled by then-President-elect Donald Trump to provide strategic and policy advice on economic issues. On April 7, 2021, Dimon came out against the state and local tax deduction, implying that it was a tax deduction primarily for the rich, saying that states like California, New York, New Jersey, Connecticut, and Illinois continue to fight for unlimited state and local tax deductions, even though they are aware that over 80% of those deductions will accrue to people earning more than $339,000 a year. Chapter 2, Section 5, London Whale. In the case of the 2012 JPMorgan Chase trading loss, according to a U.S. Senate report published in March 2013 after 9 months of investigation, Dimon misled investors and regulators in April as losses rose dangerously to $6.2 billion on a monstrous derivatives bet made by the so-called London whale Bruno Ixil. According to Carl Levin, chairman of this panel, JPMorgan had a trading operation that piled on risk, ignored limits on risk-taking, hid losses, dodged oversight, and misinformed the public. Dimon dismissed press accounts of possible losses in Ixil's book as a tempest in a teapot on April 13, 2012, when he knew that Ixil had already lost $1 billion, which led Levin to say none of those statements made on April 13 to the public, to investors, to analysts were true, and the bank also neglected to disclose on that day that the portfolio had massive positions that were hard to exit, that they were violating in massive numbers key risk limits. Dimon corrected that wrong information a month later, in May 2012, before the true damage was revealed, after U.S. Securities and Exchange Financial Watchdog started reviewing the losses. Chapter 3, Personal Life. In 1983, Dimon married Judith Kent, whom he met at Harvard Business School. They have three daughters, Julia, Laura, and Cara Lee. Julia and Cara attended Duke University, while Laura is a Barnard College graduate and freelance journalist who formerly worked for New York Daily News. Dimon was diagnosed with throat cancer in 2014. He received 8 weeks of radiation and chemotherapy ending in September 2014. In March 2020, at the age of 63, Dimon underwent emergency heart surgery. The reason for the surgery was to repair an acute aortic dissection, a tear in the inner layer of the aorta, an artery that is the largest blood vessel in the body. According to JP Morgan, Dimon recovered well from surgery, with Gordon Smith and Daniel Pinto running the bank until his return. In April 2020, it was announced that Dimon returned to work in a remote capacity due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Chapter 4, Awards and Honors. 1994, the Browning School Athletic Hall of Fame. 2006, Golden Plate Award of the American Academy of Achievement presented by Richard M. Daley, the Mayor of Chicago. 2010, the Executives Club of Chicago's International Executive of the Year. 2011, National Association of Corporate Directors Directorship 100. 2012, Intrepid Salute Award. 2016, America's Society Gold Medal.